Hey, my name is Matt McCoy. I'm a certified Ableton Live trainer, and these are the top 10 features in Ableton Live 10. Live 10 comes with an improved interface with a new font, an updated color palette, the appearance of clips are different in session view and arrangement view, MIDI notes in the piano roll are now in the color of their MIDI clip, and Live 10 comes with 5 new themes. In Live's new file browser, you can now search and install new packs and install updates. The new browser also includes a new color feature, which lets you set tags for your favorite sounds and clips. Right-click on a tag to rename it. You can assign new tags by right-clicking or by using the number keys 1 through 7. Live 10 gives you new export options. You can now export your audio as WAV and MP3 simultaneously. In your audio output config settings, you can also set custom names to your audio outputs. Your audio output custom names will show up in the audio out select box. Live 10 now lets you choose between 3 different click sounds. Choose from classic, click, and wood. You can also choose the rhythm of your metronome. Live 10 also includes improvements to the mixer. Right-click on a pan knob to enter split stereo pan mode, which will give you now more control over panning of your tracks. You can also quickly reset knobs and sliders to default by double-clicking. In arrangement view, you can now move individual clips using the arrow keys and holding command for finer adjustments. You can also activate and deactivate selected portions of clips. If you hold Alt while resizing one track, it resizes all of them. In Live 10, you can create groups within groups. You can also set the color of all the tracks within that group by right-clicking and choosing Assign Track Color to Group Tracks and Clips. In Arrangement View, fades are always visible in the content lane, giving you quick control over the fades and adjustments. In Arrangement View, you can now turn on a Global Automation mode by using the Global Automation button. This now makes all the automation lanes visible in Arrangement View. Capture is an exciting new way to get music into Live without the stress of recording. Simply press the Capture button in order to create a session clip which contains the last phrase played without the need for you to activate recording. Live then plays back the captured loop immediately, and it's ready for you to add more material. Live is now always listening for your next performance. Live 10 also gives us a handful of new devices and audio effects. Wavetable is a brand new instrument for Live. It's a dual oscillator synthesizer with flexible modulation. Echo is a new audio effect for modulation delay, which gives you a wide range of new sounds. Pedal is another new audio effect, which is inspired by distortion pedals. Drum Bus gives you an analog-style drum processor that gives body and character to a group of drums. The utility device also received a few improvements, such as a mono switch, a bass mono switch, and the left-right buttons now invert the input signal instead of the output signal. And that's a quick overview of some of the best new features in Ableton Live 10.